We've heard of amber alerts and silver alerts, but what about a camo alert? Its aim is to find missing veterans. State Representative Heather Fitzenhagen is proposing it. Now, NBC2 Chief Political Reporter Dave Elias shows us how it would work.
Well, a camo alert would work a lot like an amber alert or a silver alert. It would warn motorists of a missing veteran both on roadsides, and it would even warn you on your phone.
It's no different than a silver alert or an amber alert. The same basic information is going out, just saying this person is missing.
Veteran advocate Keith Campbell supports the idea of law enforcement issuing a camo alert for veterans who may be at risk.
This bill will help them be able to reach out to organizations like ourselves and others in the areas of where the veterans are missing and help find the veterans.
Others, though, are skeptical about whether the alerts will make a difference.
You can't be stopping to look at an amber alert on your phone. So what's the relevance with that?
Well, the red are additions.
Michael Drycorn authored House Bill 1051.
Unfortunately, encountered with this post-traumatic stress syndrome that leads people to suicide.
Veterans or their caregivers would have to register them in order to issue a camo alert on road signs and to the media.
For a veteran is not in the program, there will not be a camo alert made for him.
A separate bill, though, would keep the registry from becoming public information.
That list is held in confidence at the state level.
Now, the bill also says that anyone who creates a false camo alert would face a first-degree misdemeanor. In Fort Myers, Dave Elias, NBC2.